Welcome to the Pain and Wellness Health Channel. I will break down basic concepts and terminology about pain in a way that is easy to understand. And once we cover the basics, we will dive into real patient cases, focusing on how I diagnose and manage pain. All the information comes from scientific research, including my own published work, and is based on solid evidence. Chronic pain is a big problem everywhere. In the United States, more than 1 in 5 people suffer from chronic pain, costing around $560 billion every year. In Canada, up to 8.3 million people may live with chronic pain by 2025, with costs reaching $52 to $55 billion by 2030. Chronic pain affects certain vulnerable groups more, like older people, women, veterans, those without jobs or living in poverty, the LGBT plus adults, indigenous people, and other racial and ethnic groups with historical trauma. Everyone feels pain at some point, except for a few rare exceptions that I will talk about later. The words pain and suffering are frequently used as one and the same, but they are not. Pain is a physical sensation or a signal indicating a threatening event within the body due to stimulation of nerve endings called nociceptors by something harmful, like a pinch, pull, heat, or acid. On the other hand, suffering is often described with emotional terms, such as distress, misery, agony, or anguish. Suffering involves thoughts, beliefs, and judgments, and reflects the human experience of pain. Key points to remember. Pain is always personal and influenced by biological, psychological, and social factors. The perception or feeling of pain and the stimulation of pain receptors called nociceptors are two different things, as pain perception involves also a degree of suffering. Chronic pain can also be learned through life experiences. While acute pain warns us something is wrong, chronic pain on many occasions does not serve a useful purpose and can negatively affect our daily lives and mental health. We express pain not just through words, but also through facial expressions, body movements, and other behaviors. Most of the times, when a person experiences pain from a back strain, kidney stone, or a toothache, they usually get better once the problem causing the pain goes away. But some people develop long-lasting chronic pain. Chronic pain is defined as pain that lasts more than 3 months. While it can be linked to chronic health conditions like arthritis, in some cases it continues even after an injury has healed, becoming a stand-alone symptom. We all know people who suffer from long-term pain. However, there is no clear link between the amount of tissue damage or injury and the level of pain someone feels or how much it affects their ability to function. Some people feel very little pain despite significant injuries, while others feel a lot of pain with very little injury or no injury at all. In following episodes, I will discuss real patient cases that show exactly this point, that the amount of tissue damage does not necessarily tell us how much pain an individual experiences. Thank you for watching this episode on the Pain and Wellness Health Channel. If you like what you heard, subscribe. In the next episode, we're going to talk about how pain is created. If you have any comments, please write them down in the comment section below. See you in the next episode.